Hello, I am back. So today what we are going to talk about are the goals which I mentioned and I spoke about in my last video, and I hope you enjoyed that video. And I was a little nervous, I must say, because you know, sharing personal stuff, especially goals, other personal stuff are okay, but especially goals which are so dear to you and you share, so I was nervous about it. But anyway, I did it and I'm very proud of it because I overcome my hindrance of probably not hindrance but came out of my comfort zone and did something very different than what I usually do. So So today what we're going to talk about are how I'm going to proceed with this goals. So this video is going to be in two parts. Since the goal, there are five goals, and I think in one video it will be too much for you also to absorb it. So I'm going to break this video into two parts. So I'll be talking of first few goals right now, and the next few goals we'll talk about in the next video. So let's get into it. Okay. So there are three questions that I ask myself. I have mentioned about this in my previous video of processes, how I process my goals and how I do, I journal it. I think the link of it you can see somewhere up on the video. One is why I'm doing it, second is how I'm doing it, and third is the monitoring part of it. The how do I monitor my goals and how do I track them? So these are three questions. So I feel all these three questions are very important because you need to know why the heck you're doing it at the first place. So let's get started with the first goal of mine. So the first goal is health and spirituality. The first question that I ask myself is why I want to do it. So the first reason is to be fit in my physical form. So we have so many things that we do in our day. We get up, we go to work, we bend, we stretch, we go in different angles. So to do all these things happily, you need to have a strong physique and a flexible physique. So that's the first reason why I want to do it, to concentrate on my physical health. The second reason is to concentrate on my mental health. Physically you're fit, that's great, but you also need to have the capacity to deal with other mental tensions that you have, or mental hurdles that you have, or mental struggles that you have in life, in job, in personal life, in your ventures, anywhere. You need to have a very strong and stable mind to actually take good decisions, well decisions that are actually good for you at that point in time. So this can only happen when you have a stable mind and you are able to actually give complete justice to it. And the third reason is to actually have a strong foundation for my old age. Everyone wants to enjoy life to the fullest, and I want to enjoy my life even when I'm 80 or 100 or 120. I don't know when I'll go there, but still I want to enjoy it and not be sick and have some issues or problems, or I don't want my old age to pull me down. I know it does, but I would like to actually make my effort as far as I can to stay fit for my future too. So these are my three reasons why I want to pay focus to health and spirituality. So now let's get into the part of how I'm going to do it. So the first is I'm going to pay attention to the food that I consume. So there are different types of foods, and there are few foods that actually enhance your energy and bring a spark in you. So I would like to consume that food a little more and actually negate the food that bring down you in your energy. So this is the first thing that I'm going to do. The second thing that I'm going to do is actually practice some kind of sadhana. So sadhana, most of you may understand, but some of you may not also understand. So sadhana is some kind of practice that you do to bring alertness in your mind and always be focused. So there are some kind of practices that actually there's only one kind of practice that I practice right now. From past 1 month I'm doing it, and it has helped me. I will make a video on that someday soon. So that is one thing. The third thing that I do is actually exercise. So every morning I get up and for around half an hour I do my stretches to release my muscles into the spasm mode and open my nerves. So stretches help me to do that, and I have not started doing strong exercises still, and because I know my body, and I think stretches somewhere help me to actually go and do some heavier exercises. So I've started with stretches. So this is the three things that I do and how I'm going to achieve it. How am I monitoring it? Let's talk about this by the end of Feb. So my second goal, positively consistent in the market. So number one question is why I want to do it. So there are three reasons again to it. The first one is I would like to have the freedom of space and not be completely packed by a 9-to-5 job or something that really consumes you continuously and you cannot do other aspects in life. So I would like to have that freedom. So I think market and trading is something I also enjoy it, and plus I think it can get me closer to it. So this is the number one reason. The number two reason is I have a lot more other things that I would like to do and pursue it. But since everything needs and has some financial requirement, and I think trading is something that can help me out. So if I and also give me the freedom of time again to the first point. So that is why this is the number second point. I would like to do other things that are there in my mind, which I want to actually, you know, give wings to fly, and it's just there in my head for so long. So I'm working towards that. And the third one is I would like to spend more time with my family, be there with them when they actually need me and not tell them, no, I'm sorry, I cannot come because I have a job and I'm stuck at job. So not stuck at job, but because your job demands you to be there. It's nothing bad, but I would like to have the flexibility of being with them, enjoying with them occasions that come. And I know my mom and dad right now must be telling that, you don't come, you're lying. But no, that's not true. I would like to come, but the only thing is that the job gets me so consumed that by the end of the weekend or some festival, I'm tired to come. So this is the third reason. The second question that is how I'm going to achieve it. So I have been trading in the market from very recently, actually, maybe 2 to 3 months old, and I have not been consistently profitable every month. So what I have done is I have journaled all my trades, and I go through them in the weekend to see what went wrong and I think I will do a complete different video of how I analyze it, my market. But this is what I do. I actually journal it and analyze it every weekend, and I set myself ready for the coming week. So this is one thing I do. Second thing, how I'm going to do is I'm going to actually, once I get consistency, I'm actually going to go for investment funds and bag them definitely and have a bigger amount for trading. And the third thing, how I'm going to achieve it is actually not getting scared in placing any trades. So many a times emotions play such a big role in you, and it has played a big role with me, I must admit, and that's why it is the third pointer for me. So I'm not going to let my emotions come and just mechanically do it, and that is possible only when I analyze and backtest and see everything of my trades and my studies. So this is the third pointer. So my third goal is starting a vlog, which I've already done and you know about it. So the number one question again that comes is why I want to do it. So the first reason is I would actually like to journal my progress and my, not only progress, my downfall also. So I would like to journal it. Reason is I would like to influence others in my own small ways, in my own processes that I follow, in my own things that I do in a specific way. I can also be of some help, motivation here and there, not a big time right now, but in some way or the other I can help others to motivate. Even if I help like a small minuscule percentage of people, I think it would be worth the effort. So this is the second reason. And the third reason is I would like to grow big on being an influencer in this aspect, especially processing the goals. So I'm walking my way up slowly and steadily. So the third reason is I want to become a big influencer and a positive influencer and help others when they have difficulties of how they should go, because I am very sure all of us get confused in some point in time and we need external help, and I would like to be there and help them in the best way possible. How I'm going to do it is, since I'm very new to vlogging, and you must have seen in my previous videos too, sometimes there is less light, sometimes there is more light, sometimes I'm a little iffy, and yeah, so that is how it is. So the first thing that I'm going to, how I'm going to do my vlog is, first is be authentic. Whatever it is, and that's the reason of journaling it all. It also, so I'm going to be authentic to the core. Whatever it is, it's there in front of you. So first is I'm going to be authentic. Second thing is I have talked myself into preparing at least two videos, if not three, at least two videos before the release. So I'm well prepared and I have time for editing and again reshooting if necessary, if something is not right or if I've missed on some important points to talk to y'all. So at least I'm going to be two videos ahead of it. And the third pointer is releasing at least one video per week. So I've been continuously doing that from the time that I've released my first video. My three goals, and these are the three questions that I ask myself, in which the third one is monitoring, which I will let you all know by the end of the month. So these are the two questions that I ask myself, and I have answered them over here to you. I hope even you ask yourself why you want to do a certain goal, and what is the motivation for you. It's very important to know, even though you know it, it's good to spell it out, maybe write it down on a journal, maybe make a video like that just randomly and then have a look at it. So why is very important, and how is even more important, because you actually need to stick to it. And I hope this video has helped you in some way. In the next video, I will be going through the other two parts of my goal, talking about other two goals of mine. So till then, ta-da!